Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing good. We're going to be doing another seascape painting. This photo was a reference from BB Booth on Facebook. She is an amazing photographer, and I'm going to link her information in the description box. Here's the colors that I'll be using, and the brushes that I'll be using are as follows. I made sure that I was using a really soft flat brush. I've got a 16 by 16 inch canvas that is toned and gessoed, and I'm just jumping right in. We're going to be doing the base sky. So taking a little bit of cerulean blue, I'm going to jump right in the middle area of the sky, and some of that cobalt teal. As you can see in the photograph, she's got some really beautiful colors from that sky showing through with the cobalt. It's almost like a cobalt turquoise or teal color. So I just decided to go with cobalt teal. I thought that would be a really pretty color. And with the pretty ultramarine blue colors and the cerulean blue, all those three colors are just going to mesh really well together, and it'll give you a nice variety of some blues in your sky. So that's why I'm using three blues today, guys. I know that's a lot, but if you don't have all those colors, you can always, you know, mix whatever you have on hand. So I'm taking the majority of ultramarine blue. I just scooped some of that up, and I am working that into that cerulean blue. So the top, very top, is ultramarine blue, and then moving down towards more of the cerulean blue, and then as we get lower, we've got that pretty cobalt teal color. So I'm just going to keep working this in. I'm using heavy body Liquitex paints, which I absolutely love. And they do dry quick, so if you have an issue with paint drying quick, you might want to use a medium to try to keep the paints longer, or just use a water bottle to kind of, you know, spritz your canvas or your paints. And as I move to the right, I'm gonna really incorporate more of that cobalt teal, because you can see kind of up in that right corner, it just gets really bright up there. So here's the part that I'm taking my liner brush because I want these little tiny bright highlights to really, really show through now. So back to my liner brush, and I'm just going through with my itty bitty highlighted areas. Make sure you're focusing on where you put in the reflections at, and maybe make those more prominent in those areas. So that's all I'm doing. That's pretty much it. Just doing these little last little details here. Sometimes I'll dot it on, maybe to look like there's little splashes coming up, or you know, whatever. So this is pretty much the final part of the painting, just putting on those last final highlights. So I know that my videos can be really long, and I hope that for those of you that want to learn and actually watch them all the way through, I really hope that you guys are learning from them, and I appreciate you guys taking the time to view them. I do the long videos because I want people to learn. I want people to understand what I'm doing, and some people just can't do that when the video is so speeded up. So, you know, I just like to take my time and share what I know so others can paint. And hopefully you guys, like I said, enjoy them. So if you did watch this video and you are not subscribed already, please make sure to do so. And also don't forget to hit that notification bell to be alerted of my upcoming videos. Thank you so much, guys.